Since the onset of the COVID-19 pandemic, many South Africans have been struggling to put food on the table. Getting food to the needy during the national lockdown has become top priority for many organizations, including the Be the Difference Foundation. Team BTD has always believed in making a proactive difference to the communities to bring about positive change. And this is exactly what they're striving towards with their feeding initiative. Here to tell us more about how they're helping the vulnerable, please welcome Be the Difference Foundation founder and CEO Granthem Abrahams and Cheetahs rugby player Craig Berry. Thank you both so much for joining us this morning.
Good morning. Thank you very much for having us.
Morning, guys. Thank you for having us.
Firstly, I want to know how you've been surviving lockdown. I'll start with you, Craig. I mean, you've gone weeks without, you know, playing or even watching sports during this time. How are you dealing?
Yeah, for me, it's just been a shift in focus and a shift in passion. Rugby is first and foremost obviously my passion, but I also love to work for Be the Difference, and also I love to work with people, you know, inspiring, aspiring and providing hope to those that are hopeless. So for me it was just a shift in passion, and I dearly love both, but if the one is not there, I can just shift into the other one.
That's beautiful. And for yourself, Granthem, how are you surviving?
For us personally, we haven't really experienced the personal COVID-19 experience, because it's been business as normal for us. We've been out here for 9 weeks, every single day, seven areas a week, twice a day. So we haven't personally really felt the effect of negative, but a lot of positives. And like Craig said, our perceptions about our personal lives and what we personally experience on a day-to-day basis has been affected more positively than negatively.
And Granthem, can you please expand a little bit more on the Be the Difference Foundation? What are some of the programs offered by the foundation?
Yeah, Be the Difference Foundation is a registered NPO with PBO status. So we strive for positive youth development. We run three socioeconomic projects: development through sport, which Craig is head of sport; nutritional development, which you guys have probably been seeing for the last 10 weeks with the COVID-19, which is not a new initiative. It's not a COVID-19 initiative. We've been out here for 7 years serving the people with hope. And then we have the educational development program, which we encourage young girls and boys to be inspired by student-athlete lifestyle, not only focusing on the sport side of playing rugby or wanting to become a professional athlete, but being able to reach a 65% average so he can go to university, or she can go to university and further himself as a better individual.
I love that it covers all spectrums of life. Craig, why did you decide to join the initiative?
Yeah, for me, every athlete and every person that you work with has a special place in my heart. I think for me, I've been really fortunate with how God has blessed me and came through for me every single time that I've been knocked down. And I just want to return that favor to anyone that needs that extra push or that needs that extra help. And sometimes a lot of the kids that we work with think that athletes, especially professional athletes, are unreachable. They can't reach us, they can't talk to us, they can't have a conversation with us. I just want to change that mindset. And showcase to kids that, you know, we are reachable, and we are here to help. Because once upon a time, we were a kid that was hopeless, that had a dream in their heart, but just didn't know how to get there. And I want to be that person, along with Be the Difference Foundation, to provide kids these opportunities and platforms so that they can reach for their goals and dreams.
And how often do you have, you know, the feeding scheme going on? And how many people are you feeding on average?
For us, the nutritional program has been running for the last 10 weeks every single day. Cape Town, Bloemfontein, wherever we can reach our people, that's where we will go. We reach about between 600 to 1,700 kids or adults, depending on what area we serve at that point in time. And then we also distribute food parcels, which will obviously reach more people, because now we have about 236 families on our database that we provide food parcels to. And these food parcels will last you anything between 7 to 14 days. And these households are 5 to 10 people in a house. Currently, we're in Bloemfontein, so Craig and his beautiful wife is running things for us in Bloemfontein. We are here in Cape Town doing five areas. What we do is basically we have our ambassadors also involved in our programs, like the Cheslin Kobe's, the Damien Willemses, Kara, there's a lot of athletes that we have involved, and we serve their communities because these guys have been involved with the program for the last 4 to 5 years. I know a lot of newspapers and a lot of people see, oh, Cheetahs is involved, but if you look and you scroll 2016, 2017, you'll see Cheetahs out there serving kids, giving them school shoes, giving them school shirts. So these guys have been involved, and these guys have been digging in their own pockets, providing bread and milk on a daily basis. And we and our sponsors look at providing the meals, the cooked meals, on a daily basis. Everything starts within the organization, so the leadership has to be right. The people that are serving within that community, they have to be in alignment to the vision. So everyone has their own talent, everyone has their own ability, but the vision still remains the same, and it's very important. And remember, Craig has been involved with the organization for a lot of years now, so that's why he's able to go to Bloemfontein. He's able to understand the vision, and he's able to execute what we want him to do, and not just doing your own thing, because sometimes people would want to buy in, but you also want to add your flavor, but it's not in alignment what God wants us to do. Then we are just thinking of numbers, we are just reaching people and saying, oh, we've served 10,000 people, 20,000 people, and it's not about that. It's more than just serving a meal.
It's very simple. If you want to feed a family or to donate, make sure to visit the BTD social media platforms and, of course, their website for contact details. A massive thank you to both of you, Granthem and Craig, for taking time out to chat to us this morning and shedding some light on this important initiative that you're a part of. I hope that God blesses you even more and that you expand even more to more families in South Africa. I hope you have a fantastic day further.
Thank you very much, and thank you for the platform, and thank you that we can share our dream and our